many rulers of this period appointed historian in their courts to record the events of their rule. So many different kinds of you can say king, they have appointed historians who will write the different types of events which had taken place in their ruling period. Usually historians traveled with that ruler and recorded the event. So even the historian, they used to travel with the ruler and they used to record the day-to-day activities of that particular king. Abu Fazl's Akbarnama is a fine example of such a work. So one of the example of these type of events or this type of recording is that Akbarnama, which was written by Abu Fazl. Its third volume, Aini Akbari, highlights the silent feature of Akbar's mode of governance and statistical reports of his empire. So even his the third part of the Akbarnama, which is known as Aini Akbari, is also shows the different features of the Akbars. That means how the different rules and regulations were done, how the government policies were there, how the reports are being made during his period. A number of foreign travelers, scholars, pilgrims and royal ambassadors visited the courts of different rulers during the medieval period and left behind accounts of the period. So even different other foreign travelers who had traveled during their period, they have come, they have absorbed, they have experienced and they have written in their records, and with the help of those records we come to know the past about that particular kingdom. Apart from writing about the ruler and his administration, they also focused on the life of the common people. So not only about the governance or the different administration policies, but also they have written about the different societies, what was the division of the societies, how the societies were treated and how their lifestyle was, what are the different types of cloths they used to wear, different types of ornaments, food, what were the animals which they used to worship, and what were the animals which they used to look after, and so on. Ibn Battuta, the Moroccan traveler and scholar, visited India during the rule of Tughlaqs and wrote the Rila, that is travels. So even one of the Moroccan traveler known as Ibn Battuta, he had visited India during the period of Tughlaq and wrote the a document known as Rilha, which means travels. This book tells us about the geography of India. So in this book he had written about the different diversity, different geographical structure of our India. This Al Biruni's Tariq Al Hind, written around 1030 CE, when he accompanied Muhammad Ghaznavi on his campaign into northern India, is regarded as one of the finest foreign accounts of medieval India. So one of the famous historian known as Al-Biruni, he had written Tariq Al-Hind, and it was written during the period of Mahmud Ghazni, and it also tell about the different rules and regulation, the administration, political, economic and social policies of the Mahmud Ghaznavi. Autobiographies and biographies. Biographies including Prithviraj Raso by Chand Bardai and Humayun Nama by Gulbadan Begum, as well as autobiographies such as Babur's Babur Nama, also known as Tuzuk-e-Baburi in Turkish, and Jahangir's Tuzuk-e-Jahangiri in Persian, were written during this period. So these are the different types of biographies and autobiographies of the different famous rulers belong to different period, just like Mughal period, Gupta periods, and so on. The Baburnama provide detailed information about the flora and fauna of Hindustan. So the Baburnama, which is the the biography of Humayun, which is the autobiography of Babur. So in this book, it is written the information about the different flowers, different plants, different animals present during Babur period. While the Tuzuk-e Jahangiri provides a fascinating insight into the court politics, detail of the emperor personal life. So in the Tuzuk-e Jahangiri, it is about the Jahangir, it provides the total information about the court policy, that means how the culprit was punished during his empire, and what are the different details and lifestyle during the Jahangir's period. Firoz Shah Tughlaq also wrote his own autobiography titled Fatuhat E. Firoz Shahi. So these are all autobiography and biographies of different emperors. So as you can see in this picture, page number 132, in this picture you can see a scene from Baburnama. So it is a scene which is present in the you can say autobiography of Babur, and this picture was mentioned in his book known as Baburnama.